Before we begin today's business, on behalf of all members and staff of the Parliament, I would like to express our concern and to send our very best wishes to His Majesty the King. His Majesty's openness in making this announcement regarding his health will help to raise awareness of cancer, which affects so many. We wish His Majesty a full and speedy recovery. The next item of business this afternoon is time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is Reverend Dorothy Wallace, the Parish Minister, West Lough Fyneside Parish Church.
Presiding Officer, members of the Scottish Parliament, thank you for inviting me here today to share a few thoughts. What an honour. The book of Genesis at chapter 2 has some of the soundest advice for us in the busy 21st century. And on the seventh day, God finished the work he had done. How many of us are guilty of seeing busyness as a badge of honour? That we are lesser people if we take our time off, if we take our time to rest. Busyness has become a national pastime, a national sport almost. We seem to have a need for constantly doing. Of course, hard work is to be admired. We all have our roles to fill in making this a great nation in which to live. We each have our roles to play in making this happen. And there will always be times when we are unavoidably busy. Times when we won't always manage our day off, much less two, and forget about a 40-hour week. But those times should be the exception, not the rule. Winter time was traditionally for the human race a downtime, a time for resting up for the lighter, warmer months, for the busy soil digging, crop planting, harvesting. A time to take advantage of the longer nights, cozying in and making the best of it. Every autumn, I promise myself that a couple of nights a week, I will practice the Danish craft of hygge. A time to cozy in. Comfy pyjamas, the candles lit, devices off and a good book. A big mug of tea, or whatever. Fill the hot water bottle and put it under the duvet in time for an early bed. In fact, fill two hot water bottles, one for your feet, reclined under a cosy throw. Indulge the senses. Rest up. Alas, I am as bad as the next person for failing to adhere to the hygge life as often as I would prefer. But as servants of our country, or in my case, my small rural community, it is vital we do rest up. We cannot, after all, serve from an empty vessel. So I ask that you all take any chance you can to rest up. And working on your laptop on the sofa is not rest. Rest up when you can. Prepare your minds and bodies for the busier times. Make the most of these last few weeks of winter. May I end with words from Jesus. The Sabbath was made for humankind, not humankind for the Sabbath. May you each be blessed with Sabbath rest. Presiding Officer, thank you.
Thank you, Reverend.